This is A Bit of Biology with Mr. Ruck. Today we are going to be talking about sex-linked inheritance. Before we actually start getting into the notes and the definitions on all that stuff, I actually just kind of want to test you to see if you are colorblind, and this is relevant to sex-linked inheritance, I promise, but first, look at the pictures and see if you could see a number. On the left side, you should be able to see the number 15. And then on the right side, you should be able to see the number 5. This is a test to see on the left if you're red-green colorblind, and on the right to see if you're blue-green colorblind. In my short time as a teacher, nobody has discovered that they are colorblind in this class, but maybe you just found out, and if you did, sorry about that, but it's all right. So how this pertains to what we're learning today. So we've been talking about in genetics this whole entire time, that genes are made up of DNA, and that DNA is made up of, like, it turns into chromosomes. So DNA makes up chromosomes. We've talked about this before in class, but females and males are different primarily because of their chromosomes. Females are XX. They have two X chromosomes, and males are XY. So they have a Y chromosome, and they would have gotten that Y chromosome from their dad. With this being said, 22 pairs of your chromosomes do not determine your sex, and we call these autosomes. However, that last 23rd pair, you are either going to have XX, which means you're female, or you're going to have XY, which means you're male. So what exactly is sex-linked inheritance or sex-linked traits? The problem really lies for, it falls on the guy's shoulders, on the male's shoulders. What I mean by that is certain alleles only appear on the X chromosome. So some traits are only on the X chromosome. With that being said, males only have one X chromosome. So during this whole entire time that we've been learning genetics, you've learned that maybe you have a recessive trait and it's not very, you don't like that trait, maybe it's a negative trait, but you have a backup pair. So you might be big Y, little y, or you might be big R, little r. However, with sex-linked traits, if you are a guy, you only have one X chromosome, so you don't get a backup pair. So if you have a recessive trait, it is going to be expressed. So any single recessive allele on the X chromosome for guys is going to be expressed because we do not have a backup X. With that being said, I really do like these pictures that I have up here. I have three pictures. One is the animation. Two is the second one down here. Shows the actual size of the chromosomes. So if you see XX, females have two really long X's, and then guys, we are plagued with this little shrimpy Y chromosome. Now the reason why this is unfortunate is because if genes are on chromosomes, usually if you have a longer chromosome, you're going to have more genes. So if you have a really shrimpy chromosome, you're going to be missing out on genes. And for guys, our Y chromosome is very shrimpy. And for that reason, we miss out on a lot of genes. So if this is the Y chromosome over here, this picture on the right depicts the different genes that are on chromosomes. You can see there's a lot of kind of fancier words and they're a little harder to see, but you have something like hemophilia, both A and B, something like color blindness. All of these are located on the lower end of the X chromosome. So the Y chromosome does not express these traits. So that means if there is a bad X chromosome for a guy, if you have a gene that's bad on your X chromosome, you are going to express it. So an example of this would be something like colorblindness. Colorblindness is a sex-linked trait. And for this, The Bs, we're going to have Bs equal B, big B, B normal vision, and little b, B colorblind. The Bs are only going to be located on the X chromosome. So for females, you could have three different types of females. You could have X big B, and that would be normal vision. You would have XB, big B, X little b. This would still be normal vision because big B is dominant, but we call these females carriers because they carry the trait. So they don't express color blindness, but they do have a little b. And then in order for a woman to be colorblind, she has to be have both recessive genes. So she'd have to be X little b, X little b. If we come over to the guys, the males, there's really only two options. So we don't have the option of being a carrier. We can either be X big B, and that's normal vision, or X little b, and that's colorblind. The reason why I didn't say another X is because guys, we have the Y, and we do not get a backup allele. So if you have the big B, you have normal. If you have the little b, you're colorblind. So here are going to be some problems to practice with this. Cross a colorblind mother with a normal vision father. Questions that follow up with this are, what are the chances of having a carrier daughter, so a daughter with X big B, X little b, and what are the chances of having a colorblind son? So when you go to set up your Punnett square, you got to do a couple things. And I say step one, always identify the genotypes. So if a mother is colorblind, that means she has two little b's. So she has one X little b, two X little b. So she has both recessive alleles. The father has normal vision, so he's X big B with the Y doesn't have any B's on it because that it's a short Y, it's a short Y chromosome. An interesting thing that we're going to do here when we set up this Punnett square is we are going to actually include the X and the Y chromosomes when we do it. So we're going to include the X chromosomes for mom and XY chromosomes for dad, so that we can actually see the gender of the children in when we do the cross. So we're going to continue to bring our letters down and bring our letters across. So we still do the Punnett square the same way. The only thing that is different is now we are including the letters. So I brought the letters down, X little b, I brought them down, and I brought the letters across for X big B and Y. The thing that I would like to say about this is good news would be if you have a father who has normal vision and you are a girl, there's no way that you could be colorblind. So you have a good big B and that's going to mask the little b. So what are the chances of having a carrier daughter? A carrier has to have big B, little b, big B, little b. Don't let these questions confuse you because they usually ask about gender. So it says, what are the chances of having a carrier daughter? A daughter can only be an XX. So with that being said, it's 100% chance. Because XX right here, that's a carrier, big B, little b, big B, little b. Another word for carrier can also be heterozygous. And then the next question, what are the chances of having a colorblind son? Okay, so we are looking for the X's with the little b's. I'll use a different color. X little b, X little b. So the chances of having a colorblind son is 100% as well. And remember, it's just asking about the son, so a son would have to have a Y chromosome. So I'd like you to pause the video and try to do this problem on your own. It says practice problem, cross a carrier mother with colorblind father. And then go ahead and answer these questions once you're done. What percentage of daughters are carriers? What percentage of daughters would be normal? What percentage of sons are colorblind? And what percentage of sons are normal? So go ahead and pause the video. Once you've done this, press play and then see if your answers match up with mine. Here, the answer is like I said, start with identifying the genotype up right. this should always be your first step, setting up the punnet square step two, and then correctly bringing down the letters. Check to see if these answers match yours. And that is really all we have today for a bit of biology. This is Mr. Rock signing off.